I swear you could taste the chicken and tomatoes and the noodles and the marrow bone. But it really wasn't nothing but some water and potatoes and the wonderful, wonderful soup stone. Hanging from a string in my mama's kitchen, back in the hard time days, was a little old stone about the size of an apple. It was smooth and worn and gray. There wasn't much food in my mama's kitchen, so whenever things got tight, mama'd boil up some water, put in the stone and say, let's have some soup tonight. And I swear you could taste the chicken and tomatoes and the noodles and the marrow bone. But it really wasn't nothing but some water and potatoes and the wonderful, wonderful soup stone. It had been in the family for a whole lot of years, so we knew it was a nourishing thing. And I remember Mama as she stirred it in the water, and we could all hear her sing. It's a magical stone, and as long as we got it, we'll never have a hungry night. Just add a little love to the wonderful soup stone, and everything'll be alright. And I swear you could taste the chicken and tomatoes and the noodles and the marrow bone. But it really wasn't nothing but some water and potatoes and the wonderful, wonderful soup stone. So it carried us all through the darkening days, till finally the sunshine came. And the soup stone started in together in dust, but it hung there just the same. And ever since then, the food's been plenty, but every now and then I find that mama in the kitchen with the wonderful soup stone drifts across my mind. And again I can taste the chicken and tomatoes and the noodles and the marrow bone. But it really wasn't nothing but some water and potatoes and the wonderful, wonderful soup stone. And again I can taste the chicken and tomatoes and the noodles and the marrow bone. But it really wasn't nothing but some water